TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Tuesday, the 10th of September. India-Nepal launched South Asia's first cross-border oil pipeline. Afghan President renews calls for peace, demands a ceasefire. And Muslims across India observe Muharram. Now for all the details. India-Nepal on Tuesday inaugurated a cross-border oil pipeline that will transport fuel to the Himalayan nation. This is the first transnational petroleum pipeline from India and the first South Asian oil pipeline corridor.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his Nepal counterpart KP Sharma Oli on Tuesday jointly inaugurated South Asia's first cross-border petroleum products pipeline from Motihari in India to Amlegarh in Nepal through video conference. The cross-border petroleum products link in South Asia will help the landlocked Nepal to meet its energy demands and reduce the cost of fuel transportation. Speaking on the occasion, Nepali Prime Minister expressed appreciation for early implementation of the important connectivity project completed much ahead of schedule. Prime Minister Modi said that the 42.8-mile pipeline, having a capacity of 2 million metric ton per annum, will provide cleaner petroleum products at affordable cost to the people of Nepal.
यह बहुत संतोष का विषय है कि दक्षिण एशिया की यह पहली क्रॉस बॉर्डर पेट्रोलियम पाइपलाइन रिकॉर्ड समय में पूरी हुई है. जितनी अपेक्षा थी उससे एक प्रकार से आधे समय में ये बनकर तैयार हुई है.
Prime Minister Modi noted that regular exchanges at highest political levels have laid down a forward-looking agenda for expanding India-Nepal partnership. He expressed confidence that bilateral relations between India and Nepal will continue to further deepen and expand across diverse sectors.
India's space agency ISRO confirmed on Tuesday that Chandrayaan-2 lander Vikram has been located on the moon's surface by the lunar orbiter and all possible efforts were being made to re-establish contact.
Indian Space Research Organization or ISRO on Tuesday said all possible efforts are being made to establish communication with lander Vikram. The space agency in a tweet said, Vikram lander has been located by the orbiter of Chandrayaan-2, but no communication with it yet. The confirmation comes after ISRO chief K. Sivan on Monday admitted that Vikram had made a hard landing and the orbiter had managed to take thermal images of the lander. Lunar lander Vikram, one of the three components of the Chandrayaan-2 spacecraft, was to soft land on the far side of the moon on September 7th. Minutes before its scheduled soft landing, the communication with Vikram lander was lost. A successful soft landing on the moon's surface would have made India only the fourth country after the United States, Russia and China to achieve the feat and the first country to complete a soft landing near the South Pole on its first attempt.
Senior police official of India's Jammu and Kashmir, Dilbagh Singh, on Tuesday said that Pakistani agencies have been active in pushing militants into Kashmir to carry out terrorist activities in the valley. Pakistan has stepped up attempts to push in terrorists after India revoked Jammu and Kashmir's special status last month.
Senior police official of India's Northern Jammu and Kashmir, Dilbagh Singh, on Tuesday said that Pakistani agencies, especially inter-services intelligence and the military, have been active in pushing militants into Kashmir to carry out terrorist activities and create disturbance in the valley. He said that Pakistan-sponsored militant outfits, especially Lashkar-e-Taiba, Jaish-e-Mohammed and Hizbul Mujahideen, have been pressuring people not to carry out their daily chores.
See, PAK agencies, especially ISI and the PAK army, has been very, very active. They brought so many militants along the LOC and they have been making attempt to push them this side. Even today, ceasefire violations took place both in Jammu and Srinagar LOC area. So their purpose basically is to engage our troops deployed on the LOC and then push militants this side.
Pakistan has stepped up attempts to push in as many terrorists as possible into Jammu and Kashmir in order to disturb peace and harmony in the valley after India revoked Jammu and Kashmir's special status last month. Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan had earlier vowed the fullest possible response to India over the move.
Moving on, in a major embarrassment for Pakistan, posters and banners highlighting human rights violations in Balochistan and Khyber Pakhtunkhwa were seen installed in front of the United Nations office in Geneva.
Posters and banners highlighting human rights violations in Balochistan and Khyber Pakhtunkhwa have been installed by activists in front of the United Nations office in Geneva during the ongoing 42nd session of the UN Human Rights Council. A massive tent has been set up near the broken chair outside the UN building, which is highlighting the issue of extrajudicial killings, torture and abductions of Baloch and Pashtun political activists. On several occasions, Baloch and Pashtun activists have tried to drive international attention towards the atrocities inflicted upon them by Pakistani security forces. They blame they have been targets of military operations, internal displacement and ethnic stereotyping. Several meetings will also be held on the sidelines of the UNHRC summit in which human rights activists, members of European Parliament and other NGOs will participate.
A former lawmaker from Pakistan has sought political asylum in India, citing atrocities against minorities. Baldev Kumar, a former member of the Provincial Assembly from Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, said he was forced to move his family out of Pakistan, fearing their safety.
Baldev Kumar, a former lawmaker from Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf Party, has sought political asylum in India as he fears for his family's safety due to the ongoing persecution of minorities in his country. A former member of Provincial Assembly or MPA from Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Baldev Kumar said, he was forced to move his family out of Pakistan and is presently in India on a three-month visa. He highlighted a large scale of religious persecutions by state and non-state actors continue to take place in Pakistan.
Torture ho rahe hain zaini taur par torture ho rahe hain jis tarah zulm main ek MPA ho ke mere sath jo zulm hua isi tarah auron ke sath bhi hoga jo koi bata nahi sakta main haqeeqat bolta hu aur sari mera haqeeqat boli aur haqeeqat bolta rahunga.
Activists have long blamed Pakistan for discriminating against its religious minorities, which is manifested in various forms against Pakistani Hindus, Christians, Sikhs and also Ahmadiyyas and Shia Muslims. Human rights defenders have long blamed the draconian blasphemy laws are exploited by religious extremists as well as ordinary Pakistanis to settle personal scores against minorities.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani has once again called for peace with the Taliban while insisting on a ceasefire. The fresh calls for peace by the president came at the time when talks between the United States and the Taliban have collapsed.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani has made a fresh call for peace with the Taliban, but insisted on a ceasefire as he sought to regain a hold on the peace process following the surprise collapse of talks between the United States and the Taliban. Ghani, while attending a meeting of military leaders in Afghan capital Kabul on Monday, said peace could not be unconditional in the country. His remarks came amid general uncertainty over future of efforts to end 18 years of war in Afghanistan after US President Donald Trump last week cancelled talks with the Taliban.
Unless we reach the muzakirat be qaid u shart u sulh be qaid u shart nad aw us muzakirat bil urband ghair mumkin.
US President Donald Trump on Monday said that talks with Taliban leaders are off and that he is, however, still considering a US troop drawdown in Afghanistan. Months of U.S. negotiations with Taliban representatives ended on Saturday when Trump abruptly announced he was cancelling talks after Taliban admitted to the recent Kabul attack that killed 12 people, including a U.S. soldier. The talks were aimed at securing a peace deal to end nearly 18 years of war.
Scores of young girls from India's Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir regions have turned out to participate in a recruitment rally organized by the Indian Army. The rally began on September 7th and will continue till September 11th.
Scores of young girls from India's Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir regions turned out in fair numbers to participate in a recruitment rally organized by the Indian Army. The recruitment rally, which entered its fourth day on Tuesday, began on September 7 and is being conducted at Karga Corps Sports Ground in Ambala City. Women from Haryana, Chandigarh, Himachal Pradesh and Punjab provinces are also participating in the five-day event, which is the first time that the army is recruiting women below the rank of officers.
मेरे को बहुत अच्छा एंड प्राउड फील हो रहा है कि मैं यहाँ पे आर्मी की रैली के लिए आई हूँ एंड मैं सिलेक्ट हुई हूँ. एक्चुअली एक प्राउड मोमेंट है कि जे एंड के स्टेट से निकल के आना और ये सब करना.
मुझे बहुत खुशी मिल रही है कि मैंने ये क्रैक किया. लेकिन थर्ड जैसे थर्ड राउंड हमारा चल रहा था तो उस वक्त बीच में आ रहा था, माइंड बार बार बोल रहा था गिव अप कर दो, बॉडी काम नहीं कर रही थी, पर फिर लगा नहीं. और जब भी हमने लाइन क्रॉस की तो उस वक्त पेन का मोमेंट भी एक साथ आ गया, प्राउड का मोमेंट भी एक साथ आ गया, तो बहुत खुशी मिली.
Around 5,000 candidates had registered in the recruitment rally of the Women Military Police organized by the Indian Army. The rally will continue till September 11.
Shiite Muslims across India on Tuesday observed Ashura, the 10th day of Muharram, which marks the martyrdom of Imam Hussein, the grandson of Prophet Muhammad. Devotees on the occasion take part in the processions, chant and perform a self-flagellation ritual trying to feel Imam Hussein's pain.
Shiite Muslims across India on Tuesday observed Ashura, the 10th day of Muharram, which marks the martyrdom of Imam Hussein, the grandson of Prophet Muhammad. Dressed in black clothes, the devotees in northern Lucknow city, prior to observing Ashura, walked barefoot on burning coals, a ritual of hurting themselves during Ashura. They then carried out a procession by flagellating themselves during the day to express their sorrow on the occasion. Muharram is observed by Muslims across the world to mourn Hussein's tragic killing in a battle with political rival Yazid in 680 AD in the Iraqi city of Karbala, along with 72 of his relatives, friends and supporters.
Pure road par duties lagi hain, rooftop duties bhi lagi hain. Pura julus jo hai wo box formation mein chalta hai, aage piche daaye baaye sabhi taraf force rehta hai. मार्ग पर रूफटॉप ड्यूटीज पर्याप्त मात्रा में हैं. इसके अलावा ड्रोन से निगरानी की जा रही है, माउंटेड पुलिस का भी कंपोनेंट यहां पर है, एटीएस के कमांडो दस्ता यहां पर मौजूद हैं.
Meanwhile, similar scenes were witnessed in Aligarh city, where people dressed in black attires carried a procession to observe Muharram while beating their chests and chanting prayers. Devotees also flogged themselves with steel-tipped flails or slashed their bodies with knives on the occasion to express solidarity with Hussein.
जो हक और सच के साथ में हुआ करता है वो हमेशा कामयाब होता है और जालिम हमेशा नाकाम रहा करता है.
Ashura falls on the 10th day of Muharram, the first month of the Islamic calendar. Hussein's sacrifice symbolizes a wider struggle against oppression and tyranny and is considered a key factor in the division between Sunni and Shiite Muslims.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India-Nepal launched South Asia's first cross-border oil pipeline. Afghan President renews calls for peace, demands a ceasefire. And Muslims across India observe Muharram. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsianNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianNewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Jack TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.